guys, welcome to the channel. I'm glad you're here. If you're new here, I'm Jimmy. We're making it work. You can't see my ugly mug because you're looking at this sweet Chevrolet bow tie. This here is a Chevy Volt electric car. Customer states my window doesn't work. Can you guys check it out? Let me know what's wrong. That's what we're gonna do. So when I look at any vehicle, I always do a preliminary look around, see what's going on. Sometimes I notice broken plastic and things like that. Someone probably had this door apart, broke that plastic cover. Let's see if we can figure out what's going on with this window. If you run the power switch and you hear noises in the door, then you know the motor works and it's getting power, right? So one of the first things I always do is just try to get that window to go up and down. You guys hear that? That's the power window regulator. It's coming apart inside the door, probably plastic pulleys and stuff that broke. So we know the motor works. We know the switches work, the wiring is all good, we got power. But all that noise you hear, there's the cables raveling and unraveling on the motor and not moving the window because the regulator is broken. Pretty quick and simple. This needs a power window regulator in the right front door. We'll see if they want to fix it. It's a 2013 with 117,000 miles. They brought it in with 19 miles left in the battery, apparently. Yeah, we don't have to drive it too far. We don't have to road test the power window. So we'll let them know up front and we'll continue this video if they want to fix it. Let's do it. All right, this here Chevy Volt. She said, I need that regulator fixed because I don't want it to rain up in my car. It looks like it might be a little too late, but it's all right. We're gonna fix her up. Gonna get these covers off the retainer screws. Looks like they're 7mm. And that goes in the console. And there's something under here too. This is just a piece of rubber. And it looks like, oh, that might be a quarter inch or something. That's kind of odd there. Dirt bike going down the highway. Looks like it might be smaller than 7mm. Let's see. I got a 7mm here. Feels a tiny bit sloppy, but it takes it out fine. Strange. It's working, so it saves me a trip back to my toolbox. That's the most important thing. This is just a little cable for the door handle. Snaps in this little bracket here. And then an electrical connector for the switches. Or I should say switch. Has a little release tab. Which is a little bit of a bear to depress and pull at the same time. There you go. Get you guys right side up so you don't get dizzy. Try to never lay the door panels on the finished side too. If you're going to lay them on the ground, obviously you want to lay them down at the inside facing down and the side you see facing up so it doesn't get scratched up and stuff. You guys probably know that, but just in case. Some people don't even think of that kind of thing. And I'm not going to say that I've scratched them in the past, but I'm going to say it's possible. Just put it that way. These are also sevens. I can get the splash shield the rest of the way out. Got you guys on the ball cam. How's that treating you? How is that treating you? I just want you guys to get a good view, you know, so I'll go to any length to make sure I'm getting the right shot, even if that means using the ball cam. Should be some 10mm, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then I think there's 2 10mm on the window. I'm gonna have to lift it up manually since the regulator is broken. And the cable is wound through this thing, stopping me from lifting it up high enough. You have to force this thing up somehow. It's definitely, it's 2 10mm bolts that pinch, kind of clamps the glass. So you gotta loosen these tens, there's one down the other side too. And then once that's done, then I can unbolt the regulator and pull it out of the hole. Should come out with the motor, I believe, too. Another 10 millimeter bolt for that. And if you guys have seen some of my other videos, if you're new here, I use this airbag, which is made for when you lock keys in cars and things like that. And I use it to hold the glass. I just go until I notice that the glass and the door kind of, as soon as they puff out a little bit, it's not keeping it, it's not going to fall after that. So, tent's already got some splooge on it. That's not for me. All right. Should be good to bolt this regulator out now. See if the parts are here yet.
I doubt it.
Alright.
Now it's reassembly time. Oh, you know what? I think that needs to be loosened a little bit. Doesn't take much. Like that. Definitely don't want to drag your hands up any of this metal. Ooh, that stuff is sharp. Designed by people who hate mechanics. And they know they're not going to have to work on it. So what do they care? It costs another dollar or two to take the sharp edges off. So they're not doing it. All there is to it. Come on. This bolt sticks out too far to get it started. So you gotta take it off, put it in place, and then put it back. Now, of course, since this came with two bolts, just remember you're gonna have two bolts extra when you're putting it back together. So I usually set them aside right away so I don't forget. Go, where do those bolts go? And you'll waste about 10 minutes until you realize it came with a couple extra bolts. Maybe I'm the only one that does that, I don't know. I can't stand having extra bolts. I've taken dashboards back apart when I had a screw left over. Just because that's how I'd want it if it was my car. Now, of course, this regulator comes a little too low to get to the bolts, right? So what I'm gonna do is lower the glass onto the regulator and into the holders. Make sure it's fully seated. Take out my airbag. This little button releases the air pressure. Hook up the motor. I might have to plug the door panel in because sometimes the circuit from the master switch goes through the passenger door switch too, and it won't let it work this way, but I'm going to try it first and then we'll see. I need to raise the motor up about, the regulator up about 2 inches so I can get to the bolts, tighten the glass up so it doesn't get forgotten. Well, I tried it without the door panel plugged in, it wouldn't work. So now I'm going to plug this passenger side door switch in. They barely give you the room to get that connector in and out. Now it should work from here. I'm just gonna leave it plugged in because it's such a bear to plug in. Tighten these screws up. Took them so long to get the part that now the sun's starting to come in here, but what are you going to do? Okay, the regulator, bolts are all tight. The two window bolts are tight. This door panel's going on. I gotta pop my cable in here. You guys wanna see what I'm doing?
I'll show you.
It's a little spring-loaded, kind of strange. I'll call it a win. It's on. Now hook this back on the door. Make sure you get your little lock knob in place. Everything appears to be lined up. Oh, you know what? That's what happens. I forgot the bracket. Bummer. I looked in the holes to make sure the screws were lined up, and there was no screw holes to line it up to. It's terrible. That stuff is much more likely to happen at the end of the day when you work a little faster than you probably should. All right. Now I can see where it screws to. Filler cover slides in on the bottom, latches on the top, on the front. Boom. It's easy. Down. To learn the window, you hold it up. Just a few seconds, and then let go. Now it should auto down and auto up. Sometimes it takes a couple tries. Oh, you know what? It might not auto up. There's no A on the button. When it's an auto feature button, it'll have an A on it. Since it's the passenger side, I bet you it doesn't. It probably only does it from the driver's side. There you go. Boom. This one's fixed. Oh, I got to air up the tires for them too. I'm gonna back it up off the lift so it's a little easier to get to all four tires. I'm not going to video the tire pressure, but remember when I mentioned working faster because it's the end of the day trying to get stuff out? I forgot the water shield, so I had to take the door panel back off a third time and make sure it was done right. I wouldn't have slept over the weekend if I hadn't put the water shield on. So, three times I took it off, and now I found out they're not picking it up till Monday because it took so long to get the regulator. So I won't get paid for it this week. It'll go on next week. All right, I am gonna end this video here. Well, guys, I hope you got something from my window regulator diagnosis and repair. Chevy Volt, it's very similar on a lot of other Chevrolet vehicles like Malibus and Cobalts and things like that. So I wanna thank you guys for watching this video, and maybe torque that like button for me. It really helped out the channel, I'd appreciate that. And subscribe if you wanna see more automotive repair and tool review style videos, and videos where I combine the two. And I'll see you guys in the next video if you subscribe. Until then, you guys are awesome.